Why Tinkernut? What do you have here? This is my homemade YouTube live streaming camera. Why stream dead when you can stream live? That's right, at long last, my live streaming YouTube camera is finally done. And if you want to learn how I made it, you can click here, beside my head. In this video, I'm just gonna finish it up and show you how it works. If at any time I'm going too fast or you just get sick of looking at me, you can head over to the project page at hackster.io. Hackster.io, why does that name sound so familiar? Oh, that's right, they're a sponsor. So thank you, all you beautiful Hacksterians. What I'm using to design the case is a free online program called Tinkercad, and I like it because it's really simple to use, and I'm a really stupid person. So what I did was I made small scale models of the camera and the Raspberry Pi and the battery, and with it as a whole, I can then create the case around it, which is what I did with these parts. Pretty crazy, huh? Welcome to CAD. Save it, export it, you're done. The 3D print is done, and I think it turned out pretty darn well, if I do say so myself. All right, let's see if this thing works. Oh, that is nice. That is nice. Look at that. Works like a charm. I'm a genius. So this is designed to fit both the Raspberry Pi and the LCD screen. Let's see how well it actually does. Oh, look at that. Look at that. That will work. That right there will work just fine. And here's what the other side looks like. So it's got little risers for the Raspberry Pi. The camera itself is gonna go on the front and the battery is gonna go right behind. So one thing I just noticed is that's where you're gonna plug in the battery. And as of right now, that is just not gonna fit. So one option would be to take the wires and wire them directly onto the back of the Raspberry Pi. But I'm not exactly sure which wire goes where, so let's find out. So now I'm gonna consult the purveyor of all things internet, Mr. Google. Let's see what happens here, doing an image search. Bada bing, bada boom. So now that we've got the information that we need, I know exactly what you're thinking. Why does he have a can of Easy Cheese on his desk? Well, now that I know how to connect the wires to the Raspberry Pi, let's solder them in place. So I'll take the ground, which goes to the top PP5. That looks good. And then the power, goes to PP2. Okay, so both of those are in place now, but the connection is a little bit not connected as well as I'd like to be. So to hold it in place, I'm gonna add some hot glue. The camera and the battery go on the opposite side. This is the little YouTube logo, or is supposed to be at least. And I have little notches cut out on the reverse side so that the camera should fit in there perfectly. Yeah, look at that. That's what measuring properly can do for you, kids. Now the battery portion of this should fit right in behind the camera. And you want the bottom to kind of go where the bottom notch is. And then the top is gonna be for the little switching mechanism. So this should fit up top like that. And the charging port should fit at the bottom like that. And we're just gonna have to use some hot glue to hold this into place. Just be careful with the hot glue. Put it on the surface first before you put the battery on, because heat and a lithium polymer battery, not a good thing, folks, not a good thing. And then it's just a matter of hot gluing all the things. So the irritating thing about hot glue is holding the part in place while the hot glue dries. Stay. Stay, I tell you. Do not move. Let's add a little more hot glue to keep the battery in place, I'm obviously gonna need a spacer to put between it, the camera, and the Raspberry Pi. And I just thought I'd use these little supports that came from the 3D printer. All right, everything is stuffed inside and secured, but before I close it all up, I'm gonna flip the switch, see how it works. So flipped it on. Got a white screen for now. Hopefully it'll boot up here in a second. Yep, there's the boot screen. And then it should auto launch the Python script. And there we go. That is a beautiful, beautiful thing. Let's hit preview, see if it works. Yeah, so there's the screen. There's my shirt. There's me. I was about to seal it up and I realized something kind of critical that I left out. So the microphone is in here, plugged into USB, but it's enclosed. There's actually no way to hear it. Instead of redesigning it and 3D printing something else, I think I'm just gonna drill some holes, maybe in the side, maybe this side. I know it's not the prettiest thing, then again, neither am I. So now let's seal this puppy up and call it a day. But it's missing one thing. That should be white. Maybe I could just put a triangular piece of paper on it. No, I think I'll paint it. This is the finished product. You have your little camera right there on the front. On the back, you have your touchscreen LCD. At the top, you have your on-off switch. And on the bottom, you have your USB charging port as well as a tripod mount. And that should mount on most standard tripods. Just like this. Pretty cool, eh? If I were to continue to improve it, I'd probably add status lights and maybe some way to connect it to your wireless through the touch screen and some way to enter in the ID for your YouTube live stream. What would you add to it? Let me know in the comments below. What ideas would you like me to cover next? Submit or vote for your favorites at tinkernut.com/ideas. Click here to watch more videos like this, and if you got any value out of my show and would like to give some value back, please feel free to like, subscribe, comment, follow me on social media, or donate at tinkernut.com/donate. All right, that's it for this tutorial. For more, go to tinkernut.com.